D. Vaishnava Sampradaya, main Acharya after Vyas. He was from Sri Lakshmi Devi. Lakshmi Devi, a Sampradaya comes, Vaishnava Sampradaya. From beginning of Srishti Satya Yuga. But in Kali Yuga, Ramanuj had Harinam Diksha from him. And he preached that mission in India or whole world. And that is called Vishishtadvaitvad. He was disciple of
Yamuna
Acharya. He was very great learned person, and he was Siddha, perfect. Ramanujacharya first used to be in Vishnu Kanchi, where he took birth. After some time he was admitted in a school, Sanskrit school. That principal was Mayabadi Advaitvadi. Once he was teaching something, and a word came,
Kapyasan
Pundarika. Then that principal was doing
explanation.
Kapyasan means kapi,
meaning
monkey.
Backside of monkey.
And there, hips.
Backside.
Where they see.
Bottom.
Is like.
Reddish.
Red. So, Pundari Kaksha means Krishna or Narayan or Bhagavan. Eyes are like. The heap of monkeys. Then Ramanujacharya explained it that no, this meaning is wrong. Ka mane jalam, pi mane pivati. Who drinks the water, who takes the water, that is sun. And by these, by sun, rays, lotus are in bosom. So, Kapyasan means the Pundarik Bhagavan as beautiful like lotus petals.
Petal.
Then, his Gurudev became
principal,
astonished that, he will cut my all arguments in future. So I must finish him anyhow. Otherwise, if he will be in this world, he will ruin
my reputation,
the Mayabad Tattva. No one will accept. So he decided to kill him. And one day he told that we are going to a sacred place, pilgrimage. So all students should come with me. Ramanuj, all. So all with him went, and knowingly he went in a very deep forest with all boys, And he decided that, oh, here we should kill him. In the meantime, a friend of Ramanuj. Govinda, his maternal
uncle.
Brother, he told.
When they discussed, oh, Govinda was there, he knows
they
everything.
Want to kill you in this forest. And it was midnight, so dark. And he told that you should at once
run away from here.
Fly away from here, run away, anyhow. Then Ramanujacharya in the dark night, he
escaped.
Run away from there.
He make excuse.
But where to go? And it was very far away from his house. So he was thinking and praying Krishna, Narayan. He saw that a man Ramanuj told that I am going to latrine. And by this he ran away. So Gurudev could not understand that he will run away and he will know all these facts. Then he was very high class of Narayan Bhakta, so he began to remember and praying. At once he saw that a person with a hurricane, he is going anywhere. Then that person told that, where you want to go? So I want to go to Kanjivaram, Vishnu Kanchi, my birthplace, where his mother was. Then that person told, I am also going there. And that way was of 2-3 days. But in 15 minutes he told that we have reached here.
Sri Rangam.
Sri Rangam. Vishnu Kanchi na Sri Rangam. Na na. Sri Rangam na. Vishnu Kanchi. Sri Rangam ta piche geche. And then, oh, you have come and you can go to your house.
Thank you.
He astonished that who is person?
He could not find where he went.
Disappeared. Then Ramanuj went to his house. But he never told to anyone this fact, because he has some honor for Guru. Then the teacher saw that, oh, Ramanuj has run away from here.
No, they thought.
Again he returned back.
So they thought that, oh, we are very lucky that we have not to kill to get his sin. Or maybe any ferocious animal swallowed him. Very good.
He thought that any animal had. But when he returned after 2-3 days or 4 days, he said that Ramanujacharya was there.
Lakshman.
Oh, how he came? Then again he invited Ramanuj, you should come and study. Again he came. Ramanujacharya studied there. After some time, he defeated that person and he left that person. Now he was in Vishnu Kanchi. He began to teach Sanskrit.
He opened his own school.
And paid Upanishad Shastra through students. So many used to come there. At that time, Sri Jamunacharya, who was in Sri Rangam, he sent as his disciple that you should go. Ramanuj boy, man, Desi?
Lakshman Desi.
Lakshman Desi. Very learned, young person. And after me, only he can be
Acharya
of this Sriyangam. I think no one is like that. So you should go and inspire Sarvakti and to come to Sriyangam. But he was of low cost. That person with his wife went Kanjivaram and he began to talk with
Lakshman
Ramanujacharya, and as in few days Ramanujacharya became very attracted to him and began to serve him, though he was low and he was high class of Brahmin, began to serve. And he also used to serve to his wife, both as a guru, Shiksha Guru. Ramanujacharya, wife, very durmukh. Durmukh means very harsh.
Harsh words.
Harsh
behavior.
Speech.
Huh?
Behavior.
Harsh speech.
Behavior.
Harsh speaking.
With Ramanujacharya also, he used to
quarrel
with him. So actually Ramanujacharya wanted that I should give up this lady and I should give up everything and I should take renounce order. In the meantime, Ramanujacharya was teaching. A person came to him. One day, the wife of that
bhakta,
that teacher,
Purna Pragya na ki naam?
Or naam ta ki?
Purna Pragya chilo ki?
No. Purna Pragya to or naam. Madhvacharya. Ye to naam.
Any
naam name. And his wife was
fetching water,
pulling water from a well. And in the meantime, Ramanuj's wife came and he was also
pulling water.
So when that lady, wife of that
Bhakta
person, was pulling water from his pot, one drop went to the pot of Ramanujacharya's wife fought. Mm-hmm. Understand? And then she began to rebuke and to make so many gali.
Abuses.
Abuse her.
Very badly.
Then she became very unhappy and told to his wife,
husband.
And then they both decided that we should go away from there. We should not be here. Because the behavior of Ramanujacharya's wife, very bad. Anyhow, Ramanujacharya knew this fact. Then he was thinking any bahana,
excuse,
that I should give up all these things. One day, a Brahmin came to Ramanujacharya. Oh, I have not taken anything from 2 days. I am very hungry. Please give me something to eat. Then he told that you should go. My house, my wife is there. She will give you. He went there and told that Ramanujacharya has told, Lakshman Desik has told that you should give me some food to eat.
Get out!
You should go back. You should go to him. I have nothing.
am servant of all, I am cook.
Then
Ram, get out,
he insulted and he went to Ramanuja Acharya again and told Ramanuja, oh, well, he wrote a letter that, oh, my dear daughter, my son, marriage is to be done, so you must come with Ramanuj, your husband, in that marriage ceremony. And that letter was given Haldi.
Turmeric.
And it was
wrapped by a red
with
string.
A narikel,
string,
coconut. It was binded in a
red thread, red string.
Thread means, so Indian thread, they bind it.
Kaluya.
You have?
No.
I saw anyone.
Yeah, you saw.
Oh, that. But it was colored.
Red and yellow mixed.
So, when he again went to his wife and gave this letter, oh, she became very happy.
Overjoyed.
And?
Cooking.
Oh, you have come from my father's house? And then he did very preparation,
delicious,
very sweet, and with honor he fed him.
But then, she could not recognize the same person.
Then, when Ramanuja Acharya came, Lakhan, then she told, oh, Prabhu, my father has written a letter, we must go both there. Then Ramanuja Acharya, first you should go, and I'm coming just at the marriage time. But you should go
ahead.
At once. And with a Brahmin, he sent his jewel. And in the night he left everything and began to go Srirangam to meet his Gurudev, from whom he will take sannyas. But unluckily, when he reached Srirangam, he saw that his Gurudev has
left
this world. And thousands of disciples, taking his transcendental body, were going to give his
samadhi.
Then Ramanuja Acharya said, oh, for whom I came? I cannot take initiation, renounce order from him. Then he told, requested,
please show
that
him.
I have come from Kanjibaram, my name is this. Oh, I have determined to take
sannyas
from him. I think that he is my guru, so please keep it here, and I want to see his whole body. They put there, kept there, and he saw that his three fingers were like this.
Puro bondo, duto khula tu pinta bondo.
Like this. Then he told you, why this? Anyone could not answer. And then Ramanuja Acharya told, I must take renounce order. Then one. I will explain Vedanta Sutra with Vaishnava philosophy. Then second. And third, I will preach Vishishtadvaita Vad, what my Gurudev Jamunacharya wanted. From me, I will preach everywhere. Then he took sannyas there. And then he was. Ramanuja Acharya then became Ramanuja. His Gurudev, Jamunacharya, there were so many disciples, prominent. Some were grihastha, some were renounce order. Very, very learned. So Ramanujacharya, for some days, to each disciples,
many prominent disciples,
and served them and studied. He knew what the was the mission of his Gurudev. Some 6 months here, 6 months here, 3 months there, 1 month there. In this way he learnt from every learned disciples. And then all together decided that he should be the Acharya of Srirangam in spite of his Gurudev. And then he was there. He became Acharya. One day his Gurudev had told that what mantra I am giving, you should not give to anyone. And then he, Om Narayanaya Namaha, this mantra gave.
Buddha, before.
Then when?
Before.
Now.
Ramanujacharya.
After Acharya or before?
Now, before. Sannyasa Ramana Gage.
Then he told,
secret.
And don't tell to anyone. Only you should in mind return as a mantra.
If you tell, you will be going down.
If you will do, then what? Your mantra shakti will go away. Ramanuja Acharya, he told that if anyone hear this mantra,
they will deliver,
he will be at once
liberated from this world.
Then Ramanuja thought, oh, no harm if I am
losing the mantra shakti, no problem.
My mantra should be go away.
Result.
But I will tell to all. And then he in Srirangam temple on the wall he stood up and began to tell, oh, thousands of persons coming. You should chant Om Narayanaya Namaha. All became Vaishnava. Guru told him, what are you doing? Your mantra will be in vain. Because you have no harm, Prabhu. My mantra should go, but all should be liberated. In this way.
Then his Gurudev very
then
happy.
To fulfill his Gurudev,
order.
This translation.
Commentary, Vyasa.
Commentary of Vedanta Sutra.
He went to Kashmir. Kashmir, you know? And there was a Shakti Pit.
Sarada Pit.
Established by Shankaracharya himself. And there was a Bodhayan Vritti. Bodhayan was in very ancient time and he was Vaishnava. And he has made a commentary on
Vedanta Sutra
in Vaishnava theory. Ramanuja went there with his
disciple
Kuresh. And there they learnt, they studied Bodhayan Bhashya. Ramanuja stole away that Bodhayan Bhashya. And in the midnight he ran away from there with his disciples. But
they catch him.
At once they began to search where is Bodhayan Vritti. Oh, they could not find. Oh, Ramanujacharya has taken it, stolen away, and then they followed everywhere, here, there, so many
horses.
And in the way they
catch him.
Found Ramanujacharya and forcibly they took away. Then he was very
unhappy.
Then his disciple Kuresh told, oh, no,
don't worry.
Don't be worried.
Don't worry.
I remember all. And then at once he sat and wrote Bodhayanvritti whole. Then Ramanujacharya became very happy and came, and he then wrote Sri Bhashya and fulfilled the. And there are so many histories.
Kuresh, Kuresh.
Kuresh. In my, when I came to Guru Maharaj, first I read Ramanujacharya's life also.
And then you run away from home also. Then you also run away from home.
They took the eyes of Mayavadi, Kuresh. And when he met with Ramanujacharya, at once eyes came out.
New eyes.
Cured.